Channel 2 Action News has obtained new documents claiming Atlanta Police Department leaders condoned and even encouraged elite officers to conduct illegal public strip searches on suspects. New at 6, Channel 2's investigative reporter Aaron Diamond is live at the federal courthouse in downtown Atlanta with the latest case involving APD's now former Red Dog unit. Aaron.
Yeah, these are the sworn statements given by two former Red Dog officers filed here just the end of last week in federal court. They're part of a big stack of new documents, which a lawyer for one of the alleged victims says will back up his client's claims.
The city of Atlanta again under fire over allegations of troubling tactics used by members of the Atlanta Police Department's now disbanded Red Dog unit.
They just thought they could get away with it.
Attorney Mark Bowman is lead counsel on a federal case filed by Ricky Sampson, claiming Red Dog officers publicly strip searched him looking for drugs back in 2010.
They have flat denied that there was ever a problem with a pattern in practice by Red Dog officers of strip searching and humiliating people over the years.
So far, the city has spent more than $2.5 million taxpayer dollars to litigate and settle similar suits over illegal strip searches.
One of two things happened. They were telling the truth that there was a problem and paid millions of dollars because of it. Or they paid millions of dollars for a problem that did not exist.
And while APD has never officially admitted to any practice or policy to strip search suspects without probable cause, hundreds of pages of new court filings in the Sampson case include sworn statements by two officers named as defendants. Cayenne Mays wrote, "I was trained and instructed to search any pockets or special pockets that might be located in the subject's pants or in their underwear." Officer Stallone Davis swore, "What I and others did was reflected in our reports and known to supervisors. Only when people started filing complaints did anyone in command administration tell us we should stop these strip searches." On Monday, APD sent us this statement saying, in part, "Mr. Sampson's lawsuit has no merit and the allegations of former APD officers relating to the lawsuit are baseless."
And again, APD long ago disbanded that Red Dog unit, and the department says it has ramped up training on Fourth Amendment issues for all of its officers. We're live in downtown Atlanta. Aaron Diamond, Channel 2 Action News.